Welcome back, Danger Cats, to another Danger Cats podcast. Uncle Hack, as always. First off, let's get right into it. Thank you to the Danger Dong Patreons. Darren Miller, Travis Cornelius, Sean Brewer. Appreciate you signing up for the Danger Cat Patreon. Also, Podcast 69. Use that at dangercatshop.com. Get a little discount on your order. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Dangercatshop.com, podcast 69, 15% off your order. And here is the episode. Welcome back. Welcome back. Quarantine life. Everybody's going fucking bananas. Losing their fucking shit, sitting at home. Oh, God. My sleeping schedule is just horrendous right now. Half the time, I don't even know what fucking day it is. It's horrible. I don't know. I'm getting used to it, but I think a lot of us are getting frustrated, you know? A lot of us are getting very frustrated. You can see it at the grocery store the most. That's what I find that people are... Well, that's the only human interaction I get. I live by myself. I do a lot by myself. So it's just a strange, strange time. And we have no idea what the future looks like. We have no idea when this is going to be over and done with. Nobody has a clue. Prime Minister. Oh, my God. Let's talk about this first and get it over with. The whole talking moistly thing might be the dumbest fucking words that have come out of his mouth since People Kind. Like, it's just embarrassing at this point. We're in the middle of a pandemic. Whether it's the middle, the beginning, the end, it doesn't matter. And this jerk off hops on national television and says, avoid talking moistly to one another. What in the fuck? Like, it's just getting more and more embarrassing to have this cuck as a leader. It tears me away to know that, you know, there's men that went to war to make sure this country was ran by a cuck like that. It eats me up. Like, you think of all those veterans that went and sacrificed their lives to have this shit go on. It just makes you sick inside. For some jerk off. Yes, and make sure that we avoid talking moistly to one another. Ugh. Like, it's just... First off, like... Why? Why is that your advice? How is that your advice? When... Like... Fucking Christ almighty. It's just embarrassing. You know... Our prime minister is literally the only one that's sitting at home. Oh, I'm self-quarantined. You know, the UK prime minister, he's in ICU battling to get back to make sure he does well for his country. Ours can't be bothered to leave his fucking house to go give us a nice, you know, speech. You look at provincial leaders here in Canada and like... fucking Doug Ford looks stressed. That guy looks like, you know, like he's got to watch about a slaughter go on in front of him. He looks stressed. I feel bad for that guy. As much of a dope he can kind of be, I feel bad for that guy. Like, shit. It's just, and then Big Trudy can't be bothered to leave Well, I'm going to self-quarantine for 49 days. Fucking pussy. Talk moistly. Remember not to talk moistly. My God. It's so embarrassing as a Canadian. And Americans are like, at least you don't have Trump. Look at Trump. Look, you want to compare Trump to Trudeau? All these Yankees that are like, oh, I wish I had Trudeau as leader. No, you don't. You would have been bought and sold to the Chinese in the UN yesterday. You think Hillary Clinton's bad? Have Justin Trudeau. Fuck me. It's just so embarrassing as a Canadian. And then, like, to have someone say some shit like, oh, at least you don't have Trump. Shut the fuck up. That guy is so patriotic. I'm 90% sure he would bleed blue, red, and white. Like, fuck. Big Trudy just has his hand up, or the Chinese has their hand up his ass, running him like a fucking puppet. And for those asking that are watching on YouTube, this is just water. I got a big mason jar and it looks like there's hooch in it, but I just use this big mason jar for my water. I'm not sitting here drinking hooch. I don't know if I could sit around and booze by myself. I'm going mental as it is. I don't need to be sitting here drunk with my own thoughts. That's a dark alley alone with people. That's a dark alley to be sitting there with my buddies having conversations right now in quarantine. I like when I'm boozing, I like to be out in crowds and making jokes, meeting new people. I couldn't sit at home right now and just got shittered. I did one night accidentally when I was doing those live streams. Mixed one. I didn't eat supper that night, and what a mistake. Next thing you know, it's like 12:30 in the morning and I'm half snapped and I'm like, okay, we're not going to get into a habit of this. Like, that's just a horrible habit to get into. All right, every night we're just going to get half corked before we go to bed. But hey, if you're doing it and it's working for you, power to you. It's almost like a little vacation for those ones, for those people that are just been grinding, busting their ass for the past 5 years. And now they get this like month off just to be home and kick their feet up. Oh, it's got to be nice. But the anxiety though, the anxiety of not knowing where your next paycheck could be coming from if you don't qualify for the government handouts. But it's still like they're still going to tax you on it. So it's like these fucking idiots that are like, oh, well, it's like free money. It's not free money. Because at the end of the year, they're going to be having their hand out and be like, hey, remember that dough we gave you? Time to chip some chips back, buddy. It wasn't free. It's the dumbest fucking thing. You think the government's going to hand you free money? Come on. Use your head. But it is scary. It is super scary. Like, we're talking, you know, there's some people out there that are just, you know, they're broke. They're poor. There's poor people. That's just the reality of the world. And some of them don't know where their next meal's coming from. And that, like, kind of fucking tears at my heartstrings, you know? Like, I don't know. Like, some kids, especially kids, I don't know what it is. Like, because an adult can make a conscious decision. And that's where kids, like, it bothers me. Because the selfishness and stupidity of some parents, some kids have to suffer sometimes, which to me isn't right. So when these social programs come out where it's helping children have meals, make sure they're eating, get them into sports programs, like, I'm all for it. Just because, like, man, there's some fucking stupid people. There's some horrible parents out there. There's also good parents that are just like, you know, they just got dealt a shitty hand. They just got dealt a shitty fucking hand and they're trying to make the best hand out of it possible, but it's just never good enough. But they keep waking up and grinding, and I, you know, hats off to you. Me and, like, growing up for me, my father wasn't around. So my mom was kind of, we went from, you know, I can't remember when he left, but my mom had one decision. It was either sit around, cry, and fucking boo-hoo, poor me bullshit, or, you know what, I got to make sure that my kids are clothed, fed, and have a roof over their head. And that's what she did. And there was she didn't date anybody until I was like 14. It's like 11 years of just like straight grinding to make sure that me and my sister had as much as we possibly can. So I hold, like, when somebody's like, oh, well, I'm tired, I'm this, I just, like, I think in my head of what my mom went through, you know, like the mental grind. She had like that Navy SEAL mentality where it's like, I'm not going to give up. I'm not, like, sure, there's breakdowns. Everybody breaks down. You got to hey, emotions build up, let it out, talk to somebody. I've talked about it on here numerous times, and there's nothing wrong with that. I don't understand this whole, you know, macho mentality needs to be, oh, I can't talk about my feelings or it makes me a pussy. You know, some of the fucking toughest guys I know or you've listened to can talk about their fucking emotions. Like, understanding them, I think, is the biggest part. I've been listening to a lot of, sorry, I'm just in the chair here. I've been listening to a lot of podcasts with Navy SEALs talking and speaking about, you know, overcoming adversity, how they control their emotions, owning the moment, and having that rock solid mentality of just pushing forward. And it's the same thing. All of them have this, you know, you got to understand yourself. You got to understand your emotions. It's okay to be emotional and it's okay to ask for help. Like, I was listening to one guy talk, and once he was back from a couple tours, I believe he was, I can't remember what he ended up. I think he ended up like staffed somewhere. I don't know. I shouldn't fucking speak this guy's story. But anyways, long story short, his wife was going through addictions to whatever it was. I don't know. But he was scared to ask for help. And when he did, he was happy, like happy that he did, because his like the Navy SEALs team was right behind him. His higher ups were just like, no, man, you got a problem at home. You got to go take care of it. You know, like, here's a guy that can go to a place like Afghanistan or Iraq and go there to face war. War is one of the scariest fucking things on this planet. When you think about that, not too many people have the balls to go and fight. I'm clearly one of them. But if push came to shove, say, argument's sake, China came and invaded Canada, I'll put up a fight, but I'm not asking for it. I'm not seeking it, if that makes sense. So it's, I don't know. It's just like figuring it the fuck out. Especially right now is like, it's a weird time because you're sitting around a lot. Like you can't go, like for me, if I was in my hometown down in Tabor, I would be out at my cousin's ranch helping work, or I'd be out on their farm working. But I'm up here in the city in my condo just sitting with my thoughts all day long, and it's driving me crazy. But it's also teaching me how to control my emotions too, which I've never really took time to figure the fuck out. And kind of digging those areas in the brain that I've never really went down, which is strange for me. And it's kind of good because you feel like you're crazy, and it's like you're kind of connecting dots of like, okay, why am I the way I am? I say it all the time. Why do I like boozing so much? Because it's easy. I figure that one out so easy because that's how I got along with everybody. When I was younger, I would go to parties and just get shit-faced. I've always been a very happy person naturally. And I would just make jokes and dick around. And I thought being the cool dude at the party had to be the most fucked up guy. So then it carried into me becoming an adult. Oh, okay, now every time I go out, I would just get shit-faced. Completely floor-looking drunk and act stupid to make people laugh. So I was really damaging myself to in making sure that others were happy. Like, and bringing them joy and happiness to make them laugh at my stupidity, at my expense, and even at the expense of my health, whether it be mental or physical. So figuring that out now is like, now I'm older now. Like, for those that don't know, I'm 29. I probably, on this fucking camera, I look like I'm 50. I haven't been sleeping very well. I'm not drinking. I'm figuring out, you know, I got to get back. Like right now, I've never been more motivated to go work out, but every gym is closed and it pisses me off so bad. But like I was saying, Now I'm just, I know I have a sense of humor. I love dicking around. I love bullshitting and hearing people's stories, goofy ass stories and silly ass shit that makes us laugh. I'm not going to try and act like I'm something I'm not by, by going back to those old ways. Cause I that was like very damaging. Like those, now looking back, though, that year and a half, 2 years, whatever it was that we spent, just touring around, boozing and being shit bags. Was it a lot of fun? Hell yeah! I met a lot of great people, a ton of great people, but it was so fucking taxing. Like, I'm probably still tired. I am still tired, but it was. It was worth it in the end, I guess to say, because I did get to meet a lot of great people. We grew the brand. We went and had a lot of fun. I made a lot of lifetime friends off of doing that. So to me, I just wish I was a little smarter in the moment to know that the drugs and alcohol wasn't really who I am and what I needed. Like, how I don't know how to word it, but if you get what I'm trying to say, that erratic behavior shouldn't define who I am, I guess. Do I love wild shit? Absolutely. I wish I could get out more and kind of do the things I did when I was younger without having to be a fucking shit show all the time. But yeah, I don't know. It's crazy. It's crazy where your mind will take you. And when you just sit and kind of explore it, kind of fucked up. No psychedelics needed, just memories, talking to old friends. This has been great. I've connected with so many of my old buddies that I haven't talked to in such a long time. Every day I try and call somebody new, and it's been great just to see how they've been doing. What's shaking? Are you still working? What's new? How's your kids? You know, we live in such a fast-paced world. You kind of forget about those dudes that were around back in the day. And you realize how quick time just flies by, buddy. Holy shit, you know? Like, one of my buddies back home has 3 kids. I'm over here still fucking punching my clown trying to figure out if I'm good enough to date somebody. If somebody wants to date me, hey, you want to go date the asshole that's a loudmouth on the internet? Of course you don't. Who the fuck wants to date that guy? Clout chasing bitches. But yeah, it's good. Like, the sense of community, you know, now's the time we need it more than ever. Before you get in these neighborhoods, that's one thing I've noticed, like, compared to the where I grew up. I grew up, you know, Tabor, Alberta, maybe 7,000 people in that town, roughly, right around there. I believe it's about 7,000. I don't got a computer. I'm not Joe Rogan podcast. I don't have a Jamie, can you look up how many people are in Tabor, please? I believe it was right around there. And, you know, you kind of knew everybody, or you had an idea who everybody was. So, like, going to the grocery store down there, I feel like everybody's like, hey, everything all good? You checking in with everybody? Life's good. Up here is in, like, a city is so much different. And for those that currently don't know, I live in Edmonton now, but it's so much different. You know, you smile at somebody. I don't talk to anybody, so I'm fucking, you know, I'm deprived of any human interactions. So being able to talk to anybody, but man, God forbid, you know, I'm doing the social distancing, and I'm like, the grocery store by my place recently implemented a new rule where only 75 people are allowed in the store at one time. Oh, excuse me. So I'm waiting outside in the line to go get my groceries. And I look at the guy and I'm like, fuck me. We might as well be communist Russia line up to get a bowl of borscht before we head home. And he just like kind of looked at me and like, yeah. Like, man, just fucking joke around with me. I thought that was a good joke. Maybe I was coming off a bit cunty and miserable, but like, I don't know. Are these measures worth it? I don't know. I'm obviously, yes. If medical experts are saying, like, hey, stay the fuck away from everybody. But there's so many mixed reviews, you know, it's like, oh God, what is fucking right? I'm becoming too much of a skeptic now and questioning everything. And now I'm like, well, one guy's saying this, the other's saying that, you know, you read one doctor is saying, oh, even these whistleblowers, I seen one in Montana and another one in Wisconsin that, coroners are just fucking marking, nope, COVID-19. Whether it's for politics or whatever it is, it's just like, wow, when the fuck does it ever end? Like, when are we just going to be handed the truth? Now, don't think I'm crazy here. I find this stuff entertaining. And if it is true, wow, my mind will be blown. But this whole QAnon thing, and for those that don't know about it, if you're into conspiracy theories, this one is quite interesting, I will say. It ties a lot of things together that would make sense if it's true. Everything right down to like the Epstein bullshit, how people that are in power are somehow related to either wealth or like extreme wealth. I'm not just saying like, oh yeah, that rich farmer down the road that has like a big screen TV. I'm talking like, no, this motherfucker owns banks. How the bloodline like traces back. It's just so crazy how the people in power that it's just, how they're all related and intertwined, man. It was such a mind fuck. I watched this 10-part series called The Fall of Cabal. And it's just like, holy shit. There's so much information getting thrown at you. You're just like, when the fuck does this end? And if it's true, like, okay, hear me out. If it's true, all these years we've been lied to, over and over, like history is false, then that means history is completely false. Like, we got a lot of work ahead of us. And that's how I was like looking at it. It was like, okay, if this is all false, you pretty much have to rewrite history to the truth. And then then what is the truth? Now you're sitting there trying to write history books and you're like, well, fuck. Everybody becomes a skeptic now. It created like just this awful questioning period for the past week. Maybe that's what led me to like start digging in my brain and be like, okay, why is this? Why is that? But it was crazy how the Clintons are tied to this and this person. And like, I do find it kind of strange that anytime somebody wants to blow the whistle or has some information on Hillary Clinton, that they just suddenly commit suicide. Come on. We aren't that dumb, are we? We're not that stupid. Like, I don't know. But then again, like, here's my take on it. And take it as you will. You're a sheep if you don't invest some time into it. And you're a fucking lunatic if you believe it. So, where's the line? Like, when does it end? Holy shit. Like, I don't know. Like, I that whole rabbit hole of bullshit. Sorry, I'm just looking at my notes. I'm coming a little more prepared with these podcasts. Today's a little, I don't know. I'm feeling off. I don't feel as funny as spry. I've been sleeping like shit. My neck has been jacked up. It's just problem after problem. I'm going mentally insane sitting in my place just cruising the internet. That's all I've been doing is just like watching history videos and watching, you know, documentaries. I watched a great one on Nikola Tesla. I watched another, you know, about war. More so the mentality of soldiers is what fascinates me. Not so much the war. The strategy of war is interesting because, like, you look at the Navy SEALs, like, they're just straight up badasses. Those are just, that's a crew of badass men that have been through hell and back before they even, could you imagine going through a hell week? Like, what is it? 5 days, 6 nights? 6 days, 5 nights? I don't know. Fuck, whatever. Whatever it is. Ugh. Going through that training process would just mold you into a beast and make you fucking just know that you can overcome anything. If you can go through a Navy SEAL hell week, man, everything else would just be a cakewalk. Like, you look at tasks and it's just like, boom, get it done. Boom, get it done. Boom, get it done. Like, and no wonder it just molds these, like, fucking phenomenal humans. Phenomenal humans. They understand, like, the understanding that they have. And, like, you talk to most of not that I've talked to any Navy SEAL. That's a dumb thing for me to say. I guess what I'm trying to say is, like, you listen to these interviews with Navy SEALs. They all possess the same thing. I look at a task, I get it done. I look at a task, I get it done. They have this understanding of human emotion. They're usually well-spoken. I wish I was well-spoken at times, but I don't think that's in my character. I just don't think that I could ever, you know, if I walked in, I'm like, great evening, good fellows. I would hope to God one of you would take a brick and beat my brains out of my head because something changed. My brain took too many lumps and you need to finish me off. Because I couldn't live with myself. If I'm sitting there and being like, yes, this is an exquisite evening, or if you catch me walking around in public in a suit, something's wrong. Something is wrong. I got hit by electricity, and now I think that my name is Markwell, and I'm buying exquisite art, expensive art. And that's when you need to run up with a broomstick and beat me to death. Fuck, I could not imagine. I hope to God that I don't ever become that person. I will never become that person. That's the difference. I could never. I just, like, fuck, man. There's just something about putting on a suit that feels like I sold out for some reason. I can't do it. I understand there's events and things that you go to. Like, okay, a wedding. I'll dress nice. I have a suit. I'll wear a nice suit to a wedding. An award presentation. I'll dress nice, but I could not wake up every morning, look myself in the mirror, and put on a fucking suit. I couldn't do it. I would just be disgusted. I just feel like I cheated myself. Like, I'm not being myself. I'd feel like, oh man, I would just feel horrible. Like a sellout. That'd be a sellout to me. Trying to become something you're not. And you fucking see cocksuckers doing it all the time. You know, you watch it. Maybe that's what they've wanted to become. But I don't know. Some people just try so hard to be something they're not. This fucking city's full of them. I did decide. I think I'm done watching hockey. I can't fucking handle it no more. Every day they got hopeful wishes. Oh no, the NHL will be back. The NHL will be back. Fuck off with that. It's not happening. You think now anybody gives a shit about the playoffs? We're all like, yeah, I wish hockey was back. Yeah, do I wish hockey was back? Me too, I guess. But the fact that there's, after this is done and you start reading, like I said in the past, I said I wasn't going to get very political, but fuck that. I lied. You know what? I lied. suck my white ass. I'm back. Fuck you, Trudeau. Fuck the government. Fuck the conservatives. Fuck Jason Kenney. Fuck Doug Ford. Who else? Bring them on. Theresa May. Fuck that bitch. Sitting there. Sold out. We're sold out to the Chinese at the at fucking, even right down to Harper. Fuck him too. Fuck them all. You know, what happened to Canadian, like, on, as soon as you say nationalism, oh, you're a white supremacist. No, what happened to, like, Canadian nationality? What happened to that? You know, no wonder the Indians fucking hate us, or Native American. I guess the proper word would be Native American. Indians come from India, Brendan. But no wonder the Native Americans just fucking hate us. You know, came over. Oh, no, we're Canadian. Fuck. And the multiculturalism, I get it. But it's just like, man, it never fucking ends here. We're a bunch of pussies. That's what drives me nuts. We're a bunch of fucking pussies here. We bend over and show our asshole to anybody who has a fucking strong enough opinion. And if it, not even strong enough opinion, if it falls in line with this progressive mentality, and we just bend over and let it fuck us in the ass. Like, oh, well, we need, you know, we need Muslim this. We need Catholic that. We need, oh, fuck, we need gay sidewalks everywhere. It's just like, man, can't you just be happy? Can't we just be happy? And I'm not saying, like, some people went through some shit to make it how it is today. You talk to the general public, nobody fucking cares. Anybody you chat with does not give a fuck about this whole, which religion, like making sure religious people get what they want. Make sure the gay community has what they want. If we sat there and just broke it down, like if you want to wear a hijab, wear the fucking hijab. Fuck. It's always got to be something. It's always something. Well, I think we should be knitting squirrels scarves. Why isn't the government funding a program? It just never fucking ends. That's the issue. Which I'm glad, like right now, with the one positive about this is the social justice warriors are just non-existent. Nobody's even giving them the time of fucking day, which is great. You just realize that when we don't have real problems in front of our face in a first world country, we just make them up. We make up problems so that way we can somewhat feel important. And then when a real problem comes and just smacks you in the fucking dink, you're like, oh shit, maybe all this bullshit that I'm spewing out of my mouth, that gender pronouns need to be recognized with the general public, really doesn't fucking matter, because of there is tiny things in the air that can go into your system and fucking murk you. And they don't give a shit if you want to be called Zer Zem fucking Zim Zim Zalabim. They don't give a fuck. They'll kill you. They don't give a flying fuck. They're not prejudiced. They're taking out the old, the young, the weak, the strong. Black, white, yellow, it don't matter. They're just dropping them. Now, whether those numbers are fucking true or not, but that's it. That's an argument for a different day. But I hope to God it makes a lot of people realize that their stupid fucking social justice bullshit really doesn't fucking matter. And then, like, I hope that this unites us as a community more. And that we, especially here in Canada, that we get some fucking patriotism for once. You know, brave men went overseas to make sure that you were not going to speak German in the future. But we're over here just, you know, this country's selling itself out, and it just irks me. It fucking eats me alive. And I find it strange. You know, I find it super strange. Anytime you talk to a veteran, a current one, it's funny because they're angry because they go, they go on peacekeeping missions, whatever it is, fight in Afghanistan. They come back and they realize what the fuck they're fighting for. And, you know, they're fighting for a country that doesn't give a shit about them. There's a different agenda on board, and they realize it really quick. What that agenda is in their mind, I don't know. I can't speak for them. But every veteran I've ever spoken to knows that they went over there with the intention to protect the general public of Canada from evil, from terrorism, from any sort of war or, you know, threat to human life in Canada. But they come back only to realize that the Canadian government never had their back. These men and women go overseas to ensure that people across Canada never have to worry about that evil coming. And it's not like they're going over there and just shooting up civilians. And you talk to them, and you get to know them, and they're angry, and they should be angry. You know, you're watching this Canadian government handing money hand over fist to all these stupid fucking organizations, like $158 million to fight global feminism right now. Not to fight, to empower global feminism right now, when, you know, the Canadian economy is just taking a large hit. Like, what in the fuck is wrong with I don't get it. I just don't understand. You know, you got these guys that have some of them major PTSD, but they're not taken serious, because then it's just like, oh, he's just a crazy veteran. Oh, he's just thinking like, oh, well, they fought for politics. They didn't fight for peace. They fought for politics. There's some other agenda. There's a hidden agenda behind a lot of things. And you figure it out really fucking quick over there. And that's just from me speaking with them. I've never went to Afghanistan. I've never fought for the Canadian Armed Forces. So I don't know. But I do pick up on what they're saying. And it's fucking sad, you know? That these are the people to ensure that your life is protected. Your life will be the best. That you can keep living in a first world and have these problems like, oh, well, I need a proper gender pronoun, you know? When in reality, if you fucking went over there and witnessed what happens on a daily basis, even here, go on liveleak.com and try and put yourself in the shoes of one of those men or women and sit there and think of like the emotions that are going through their head as bullets are whizzing by their fucking head, because ISIS believes that Western civilization needs to be wiped off the earth, completely wiped off the earth. And these people are willing to go on suicide missions to try and fucking take out any Western civilized human or a Western civilized society. They will do anything. They will go at any expense. And it's, you know, the people in Iraq, people all over the world, the general citizen wants the same shit you and I do. They want to wake up. They want to go to work, make some fucking money, make sure their kids have food in their stomach. They want to make sure that they have a roof over their head to make sure that their kids are getting a good education so that they can have a better life than them. The general public all wants that. And yeah, there's shitty fucking people out there that they have these crazy ideologies that they will stop at nothing until... Look at fucking Hitler, for instance. Like, that cocksucker almost took over the world. Like, he was pretty damn close. Couple mistakes and we'd all be speaking German and be blonde-haired, blue-eyed. That'd be it. That'd be all. And it's crazy to think that that evil still exists in the world. Even like I was thinking the other day, like the LA riots was in what, 1990? That was like, you know, that's only 30 years ago. Like racism is still an issue in 2020, which blows my mind. We've been on this planet for how long and we just can't figure out that it doesn't matter what your skin color is. We all just want the same shit. We want to be, we just want a peaceful life. We don't want no problems. We don't want to hear about Zimzer yip yapping about fucking how blue hair needs to be a representation. Nobody, or cultural appropriation, or, you know, nobody fucking gives a shit. Nobody gives a shit. And like I said, when a real problem comes around, like a global pandemic, you realize that those problems that you thought you had really don't fucking matter. And I hope people are taking time to like get to know their family members a little better right now. You know, like getting to sit with your kids and see how they think, because we live in such a fast-paced world in Canada, even America. If you're American and you're watching, we're in a fast-paced world. You always think you're busier than you are. You're not. Really, it's where you allocate your time and what you feel is more important. If you feel your family's important, you're going to put more time into that. If you feel, oh, I have to work. Well, then when work is taken away from you, what, you know, you start to realize like, holy fuck, these people that care for me, I care tremendously for. And it's kind of a beauty in disguise, this whole shit, because now we get to sit with our loved ones and we're calling and we're talking to, you know, check up, see how they're doing, seeing what's new, seeing what's shaking. And it's, I think it's good. I think it's great. Relax a little bit. Let's not worry about, fuck it. Personally, this is what I think. If these banks and, I got the hiccups a little bit here. If these banks and mortgage companies, they fucking, where was I going with that? I can't remember. They created their own mess. Wallow in it. Not my issue. You want my fucking place? Come take it. Quite honestly, I would be happy moving. I'm tired of it. It's, you know, when this is done, it's going to depreciate in value. So I can't see me getting out of it. I bought my place. So fuck it. Have it. I don't give a shit. Then I'm not tied down to one area no more. I don't have to fucking live here. I can up and move whenever the fuck I want. You want my truck because I missed 6 payments? Come take it. I don't fucking care. Come grab it. Oh, it's going to hurt your credit score. Fuck the credit score. You know how many credit score? They're going to be handing out money like it's going out of style here pretty soon just to ensure that the bank still got you by the dick. So what do I fucking care? 0% interest? Right on, brother. Fuck it. I'm not really paying attention to the economics side of things. More so just what political leaders are doing. And I don't know. I don't know what to think about all this. I'm hoping a lot of good comes out of it, but it's going to be shitty for a while, which sucks. Completely sucks. And, you know, but I think this is a good time to really get that sense of community back. Like, you know, like I've kind of been thinking about it and it's like, man, instead of wasting my winters like fucking with my thumb up my ass, I think I'm really going to get into hunting this year. I've been wanting to do it for a long time and I just, you know, I think I'm busier than I am. I don't put time into doing the things that I want to do, and I've always wanted to go and, you know, I haven't shot a deer yet. That's embarrassing. That's fucking embarrassing. I've never went out and capped myself a deer, which I think it's time. I need to go out and get that done, get that experience, hunt my own meat. I'd love to go shoot one with a bow just to get that real primal. I think rifle hunting is it's great. I'm not docking it. I've never done it, so I can't sit here and dock it. But there would be something about tracking and just whacking it with a fucking bow, because, you know, a bullet can just fucking, you can shoot that thing in the asshole, it'll rip right through, where a like an arrow, there's just something about it that just is more attractive. Just dropping, you imagine fucking shooting a bear with a bow and arrow, man? You know how fucking gnarly that would be? You know how much of a macho man? Like, even growing my own food, dude, I've been like, I'm feeling really disconnected to my true self since living in the city, and I'm like itching. These past couple of years I've been itching to get out and get out in nature a little more, like when I was younger, and I've just gotten accustomed, and it almost disgusts me how fucking, I was sitting there thinking about it, and I'm like, damn, I've gotten soft mentally and physically. I'm fucking gaining weight just sitting around eating junk food. But I've just, main thing, mentally gotten soft and like become so dependent on other necessities like a grocery store. Not that I was hunting and gathering my own shit before or growing my own food, but, you know, like my cousins are farmers. We would go out and, you know, just that grind. And like, I worked on the farm when I was younger, so you got an understanding of how we survive. And I don't know, I've just lost touch of that primal side that I used to have when I'd fight, and like that combative self where, Jesus, I'm talking moistly right now. I lost touch with it, and it's fucking annoying me, for one. But right now we're like self-quarantined, so I can't go and get my PAL or even, you know, go purchase a weapon, so that way I can fucking go hunt. Just go shoot a fucking deer. Do I love going and getting shittered every now and then? Of course. I don't mind it. But there's just something more, like, partying's fun and everything and chasing pussy, but there's something about just connecting with nature and making shit happen and doing it for yourself. That chop wood, carry water mentality. I got to get back into that. Like, now I'm going to, you know, I even thought about starting to train again, doing jiu-jitsu, something. I need something that to work towards that isn't just always danger cats. It's always danger cats, which is good. I should always be paying attention and making shit happen inside my business. But at the same time, I've lost touch with, like, by focusing so much on danger cats, I've kind of lost touch of that, like, intense side. You know, I still have like an intensive work ethic. I can, when I want to hone in and focus, like, I will fucking get shit done. I know that. But right now it's weird, and I just feel so disconnected. And I kind of had an epiphany last night where it's just like, okay, you fucking pussy, I'm very hard on myself, which I don't know if that's a good thing or bad thing, but it's good to recognize it and be like, listen, you've gotten soft. You've gotten very soft, and it's time to harden up. Listen, come this winter, I'm going to shoot my first deer this year. And like, I have trouble with guts, like just gut. So gutting it and like, dressing every, you know, harvesting the meat is it's going to be difficult. Like skinning something, oh, there's just something so morbid about it, but it's like, fuck it. You know, if this shit really wanted to go south, can I fucking do it? Can I pull the trigger, harvest my own meat, and, you know, grow my own vegetables? Not that I would, you know, but it's good to know. It's good to know is what I'm trying to get at. Yeah, it started eating me alive last night. I was just like laying there. I'm like, fuck, I'm a fucking pussy. Fuck, am I a pussy? You know, you're not fighting anymore. You're not learning anything. You're not applying your fucking body to anything, which I shouldn't be like that. You know, I've gotten smarter, which is great. I may not sound like it. I got this weird ability where I can learn a lot of shit, but I can't process it to where I could teach. I'm not a good teacher, but I can watch something and apply it. Mechanics. I've never really been interested in mechanics, but when it comes to shooting and the mechanics of a rifle interest me a lot, like weapons, mentality of soldier and warriors of the past. That has always been interesting to me. And I just need to get back in touch with it. I gotta just do it. So yeah, this year I'm definitely gonna be, once shit opens up again, I'm gonna go get my go register and get my WIN card. If for those that are down in the States, wildlife identification number, gotta get that. I'm gonna get my PAL, get all my courses done to make sure that I can go in and actually purchase a rifle. So I'm excited, man. I'm fucking pumped. I'm really excited to get this going, man. I need something new. I'm over hockey. I could give a shit to sit down and watch hockey. I'd rather start learning like those types of skills. And I'm pumped. I'm really pumped. But yeah, that's my podcast. No one gives a shit. No one gives a shit about social justice. I need to get my shit together. And yeah, anyways, thanks for listening. Thanks for watching. Please make sure if you're on iTunes to leave a review. I really appreciate it. Also, if you're on YouTube, smash subscribe. Never hurts to subscribe to the cats. Helps me out tremendously. I appreciate you guys throughout this quarantine watching my stuff. Hopefully it's entertaining. I will definitely try and film some goofy shit, throw it up, try and make some people laugh, make some light of the situation that's at hand right now. But I don't know, laziness has got the best of me this past little while, but kind of been on a weird sleep schedule and fucking around. Then I get lazy, and like today was the first day where I'm like, nope, get the fuck up. So I'm going to start getting, I'm tired of shit. I got this bad habit right now of staying up till 4 a.m. and sleeping till like 10, which is not good. So I'm trying to get rid of that behavior and get to bed like somewhat earlier, maybe like 11-ish. And I don't know what happened there. And up by like, 7, 8 o'clock and start getting shit done. So, but yeah, remember, give your loved ones a call. Call your homies. Let them know what's up. And yeah, bring back that sense of community. I appreciate all of you. And see you next episode.